Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful soil landscape painting. So today my subject will be a floating city. So as you can see here everyone, I have here the city, the buildings, and then it's a floating city. Okay, and the background will be the sky, something like that, the sky, the clouds, something like that. Okay. So please don't forget to subscribe. If you subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes that we're getting, and all the things that we're getting to paint this painting. Okay, so I am going to start now. As you can see here, everyone, I have already the sketch. So what I have to do now is put the other painting. So I think it will not be just that hard, but I am going to change the perspective here, everyone, because I think something's off in the perspective of the of these buildings. Okay, and then I have the sketch and I do the other painting now. So I'm going to start now, and I hope that you are also ready and you can also paint this one. So I have here the blue and the white. I'm using the 1.5 inch flat brush. Usually the sky will be some light blue. If you hit some parts, it's fine. I want to make it a bit dark, especially here. I want to show the sky a bit darker. Blue and the red to become purple. A little bit white. I just have to blend the top part, okay? And the white here. Okay, here you go. And then I'm going to make the bottom part a little bit pinkish. I'm gonna put some red and then white. There. Or a reddish purple, everyone. Just blend on the edge between the colors. Just a little kid. There, so bottom everyone, I want it to become light orange because I want it to look more like an afternoon on the bottom. So clean your brush, make sure that it's clean, have no paints there. I have yellow and then red. Then let's put some. Red and yellow. So I have to make the bottom part a little bit maybe a light pink. Okay, there you go. At least on the bottom part is a little bit orange, so I don't want to touch that so much because it's still wet. I have to let it dry. I'm going to focus now on this part here. I want to add a dark color. Okay, so I have here the medium size flat brush number 8. Okay, so I have to put paints here darker. I have the raw umber. I'm gonna mix it with the blue color and then white there. A little bit of red to make it purples. Okay, there. Okay, and put a little bit of umber. My light source will be on the left side, everyone. A little bit of purple. I have to make the colors dark or solid.
blue and the umber. A bit of red and then white. Okay, there you go. Yeah, just let it dry, everyone. And then I want to have some greenish, so I want to put some blue and the yellow. Okay, so let's put that here. So this is just the underpainting, everyone. So we are just still doing the underpainting. So here, since this will be the grassland or something like that, I'm gonna put light yellow. So this is the first step, everyone. I want to put a lot of things there. I want to put the light yellow, something like that. Okay. And then here, everyone, I'm gonna put here some grayish color. So yeah, maybe I'm gonna use this reddish purple here with some white. I have to change the perspective also, everyone, because something is off with my perspective. It's not accurate. Okay. So just the top of the buildings I'm gonna change. Okay, so you can do the underpainting first, just like what I'm doing, and you can still see the details there a little bit. So yeah, just don't cover so much. I think that would be enough. Okay, so since everything is try here, spray the background, I'm gonna start adding some clouds here. So I will be using the same color here, but a little bit lighter, with more red. Gonna add some white. Yeah, I'm gonna start adding some clouds here, especially on the there. Our light source coming from the left side, everyone. Okay, I think we can put some more clouds. Even the clouds on the top, everyone, I have to put there also. I have to put a bit of lighter clouds here, but just white. Just create something like that, everyone. Some cumulus clouds. Just add the white color on the top of the brush. Just press the brush, everyone, so that it will scatter. And you can have a beautiful clouds like that. There, so Yeah, so yeah, you have now the clouds surrounding the this island. Okay, so on the top, everyone, I wanted to have some few clouds also there. Yeah, but I want to show you some galaxies also on the top. Yeah, I think it would be cool also to show some galaxies there, some stars, something like that. So yeah, maybe I'll just use this one and do like that. Just tapping technique, just the dry brush technique, everyone. Maybe you can show the galaxy like that. Just dry brush technique. I just put a few line of clouds here from the top, just a faded few line of clouds. And then you can start adding some small stars. Just a dot, small dots. Like that. Okay, you can see the stars. Okay, so yeah, you can see now the stars here. It looks good, everyone. I like that. The view looks good. It's so soft. I'm going to do first the buildings, everyone. So my light source will be coming from the left side. Okay, so I will do first some yellowish or some orange buildings. You have to add white and then yellow or a little bit of red. Use the very small brush, right? I am using the liner brush, 0 or double 0. And I'll put on the center. There, and to mix a little bit of light blue. Okay, so I'll try to mix a little bit of greenish blue on the side. Buildings are one of different colors. I'll try also to put some light blue and the white. There. And also use some pinkish think I'm gonna use a bigger brush to burn. I'll be using my smallest flat brush. On the other side, we run to be a little bit reddish purple. So we have to do it a little bit differently, each one of them. Can also put a bit of orange. Okay. Some would be a little bit of light brown. Okay, some orange and brown. You can do a bit here. Not so much, everyone, just to like that little bit of colors. Okay, adding the start now, adding some beautiful details. First, this light green, I'm gonna do a bit here, yellowish. Light or light yellow green. Straight like that, everyone, with a cross. No square. Okay. Can also do the other side. Okay. This light brown one, we can add something like that. Okay. Also add here. Okay, that looks like some sort of buildings. And what everyone can also protect that. There. And then I will use some white for this one here. And you can put some rooms there. Just that's everyone, and do like that. And they will know that these are rooms. Okay. Even on the back side, I can put those. Okay, there you go. We can put some other lights aside here. We can put some other lights that that someone is opening the lights there. Okay. Yeah. That looks fine. And then this one, we can put, we can try a pink white light them. Can do the horizontals. Just follow the pattern, everyone. Yeah. Okay. And then I will mix for a bit of dark. Okay, so as you can see now, different buildings. Okay, that's so good. Yeah, different buildings, everyone. And then this one is light yellow. Can you use some light yellow with white? There. Okay. Also the other one, everyone. Input like that. Okay. And then we can start now adding some lights on that. Okay, can put some lights and yeah. So yeah, that looks like colorful buildings. Oh, it looks so good. I like the simplicity of this painting, everyone. This looks so very simple. I like the background there. Okay. And then we can try to add some roads and city lights there. That'll be great. So yeah, I'll just try to I use this smallest flat brush I have, and then I will try to use this blue and the red, little bit white. Something like that. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit of purple and white. There. And then I want to darken some parts of. Just fade it a little bit. Yeah, Yeah, so that I can see a little bit of shaded part. I'm gonna put some umber, and this one also here. There, and then I will start now adding some. Okay, at least there's light there. And then we can put some street lights, everyone. I'll be using a very small brush, this one. And then, yeah, I think I'm gonna use some umber. Then white, and then a little bit of yellow. Yeah, you can use a plain white. Yeah, so it's clear now, it looks good. You can see it run a lot of lights there. I like the lights. Okay, it looks subtle and good. Okay. And also you can see some street lights there. You can try to put a lot more lights, maybe some cars. And also some red lights. Damn. And then we can put some other lights. We can even put some yellow lights, everyone. Okay, bro, I'm gonna darken this part here. A little umber and the blue. A little bit of yellow and umber. Yeah, I can darken this. At least you can see that this part is dark and there's no light in there. But yeah, at least there's a shadow part, okay? Which this part does not hit by the lights, and it looks so good. I like it. It looks marvelous and wonderful. Okay, so let's add some highlights on the bottom part. Those rocks there, something like that. Okay. Yeah, I think that's enough for now. I can retouch it later on, everyone. But for the beginners, I think this will be enough and looking great. Clean your brush. So I have here the yellow and the red and then white. There. It should be bright enough, everyone. You can add a bit of light brown. There, so yeah, you can see now the highlights and a little bit of darks on the other side. This part does not heat, that's why I'm using a little bit of raw umber, light raw umber, everyone. There. Okay. And then let's try a bit of reddish purple, red and blue and white. The other side of one should be a little bit more smooth, which purple. There. Okay. Okay, so yeah, I really like that, everyone. It looks amazing and it looks realistic. Floating, what they call this, floating island, okay, floating city. So the city looks good, like it. Yeah, I want also to put some floating rocks there, everyone. I think it will not be I wanted to have some rocks there that are floating. Anyway, I think it will be a different, yeah, it will look different. We'll have this raw amber. We'll put some white, put more here, some browns. Lighter. More white there. Let's put some white tracks. There. Okay, and then we can put a little bit of, and put a little bit of trees also. So we have the raw amber and the blue, a little bit of red and then yellow. Some pine trees, you can put some pine trees there. There. There, so at least there's a boundary. And then I'll be using a small brush to add some highlights. So some blue and yellow to make some light green. There, so yeah, I think that's fine. I do not need to put so much details there, that will be enough like that, okay? And the next, I am going to add some floating rocks. So I think floating rocks will give a little bit of beauty in this one, everyone. Floating rocks will give a little bit of beauty, something like that. Okay, so I'll put some floating rocks, something like I'll put first on the other side, something like that. Yeah, maybe here. I'll put some one rock here. Yeah, maybe here and then here. Maybe here and then here. I have here the peak of the raw umber. Just a plain raw umber one should be enough. I can put one over here, okay? Then the other one here. Can also put some on the other side, everyone, but for now it'll be like that. Okay, let's put some highlights, yellow and the red, and then white. I'm using this small brush, everyone. Yeah. And then you see the, but you can spread a little bit. You can blend a little bit on the edge, everyone, especially on the edge. You're seeing just the paint room. Okay, and then next we can put some lights on the right side. Okay, so blue and the red. And then white. Okay. And also here. Yeah, so don't need to make it so much like that. As long as it looks like floating there, it'll be good. I'll add one big here. Okay, you can put some smaller rocks. Okay. And also, we have to put also some floating rocks. Some white on the far, okay? I have to make that lighter. This might be another island there. Thank you. Okay, and then let's put some light orange, yellow, and the red, and then white. I can do it first, this one. To let that everyone there. Also this one, can put some highlights. And then bring this one. Okay, so I have to put a little bit of lights, light blue color or light purple here. Okay, yeah. Okay, so yeah, I think that looks so good. Okay, so I think that will be enough for now, everyone. I am very, very contented with the entire result, and also it looks good. It looks surreal. Okay, it looks surrealistic, and that's my purpose here, to paint surreal landscape like this, everyone. Surreal landscape. It's the theme will be like a city, because I saw a lot of like this painting that have houses there, but now I'm going to try to paint something different. Okay
everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.